Welcome to BioBalance Health, episode number 543. Can your genetic blueprint be changed?
BioBalance Health features conversations about anti-aging medicine. Your host is Dr. Kathy Maupin, Medical Director of BioBalance Health and a leading expert in treating the symptoms of aging. Dr. Maupin and Brett Newcomb are the authors of The Secret Female Hormone, the seminal work about testosterone replacement therapy for women, and Got Testosterone, a book that helps men choose the most effective and safe form of testosterone replacement. These books are available on Amazon or from Dr. Maupin's office at BioBalance Health in St. Louis and in Kansas City. Dr. Maupin's office is currently accepting new patients.
You know, today we're going to talk about something that you probably learned about in grade school, high school, and that was that we are all made up of genes. Every one of our cells has G-E-N-E-S, genes and chromosomes that direct the activity of our cells, they direct our health, they direct our talents, they are inherited from our ancestors, a little bit from many different ancestors. And when they come together at conception, they form a blueprint for a person. Now, these genes used to be told to us in medical school and in high school, and when we learned about genes and DNA, that we all had our DNA in the very beginning, the very first cell we were made from both sperm and egg, we had our own DNA. It was unique, and that it could not be changed. It could be mutated, which means you could have radiation change your genes. But other than that, your genes were static. You were going to be this person that was built and acted like this certain person because of your genetic makeup or blueprint. Well, that's what we thought ever since the 1950s when Watson and Crick developed the DNA spiral that you've seen. That's kind of what it looks like chemically. But if you think about it more like the blueprint in every one of your cells, it's easier to understand. Mostly, we have not used DNA to evaluate our patients. We're starting to do that now, and it's very specific. It tells us what our patients have inherited from their family members. It tells us a better history than just family history. But in lieu of that, because we don't really have a good way to look at genes and know what all of them mean, we do something different. As doctors, we ask you your family history. Now, the family history is kind of a blunt instrument. If I ask you about your grandparents and your great-grandparents and your parents and all the diseases that they had, and maybe your children and your siblings, your brothers and sisters, then I get a picture of all the things that could be in your DNA, but not specifically what your DNA has in it. Because those are just risk factors. Those are people who may or may not have donated genetics to you. So I don't know which things you actually got and which you didn't. But now we're able to actually see our DNA, and we can go to 23andMe and spend $99 and get a DNA evaluation of our health, which I think is miraculous. And I think it is very interesting to see what diseases we actually have genes for, and that makes my target for taking care of myself, my family, my patients a lot smaller. So pretend that you come in and you tell me that your grandfather had heart disease and your grandmother had cancer and somebody else had an arrhythmia, and that you have all this pile of different diseases that could possibly be yours. That's a huge target to try to prevent those diseases for you. But if I have your genetics and I know that your genes have programmed you to have certain kind of deletions or problems, mutations that you've inherited from people that were born before you, then I know exactly what your risk is. I know if you are at risk for heart disease or not, if you're at risk for obesity or not, if you're at risk for diabetes or not. So that is a very specific target. And looking at your genetics really helps us. But is that target unchangeable? A lot of times I'll talk to people about their family history, and maybe they bring in their 23andMe and it tells me that they're going to have diabetes, or they're going to have heart disease, or they have a high risk of it. And then they say, how can I outthink or outwit my genes? And before, a long time ago, I used to say, you can't, those are just yours. And that is what tells your body what to do and how to metabolize and what diseases you're going to have in the future. But we've now found out through a lot of research that there's something called epigenetics, above genetics. And we found that through lifestyle, through lack of being exposed to chemicals and things that might change our DNA, through healthy living and exercise and being ideal weight, that we can actually turn those bad genes off. I know it sounds crazy, and it's not essentially mainstream, but it will be soon. We're just ahead of the curve. This is actually very important information, because when I tell my patients, you know, I see them and they're very interested in being healthy and lengthening their life and making their life more productive. I want to help them do that. But there, many people come in and they say they're doomed. Their whole family has cancer. Their whole family has heart disease. Everybody dies early. Well, now we know you're not doomed. That isn't necessarily your future. You have a choice. You can change your lifestyle. You can stop smoking. You can stop drinking. You can eat a whole foods diet. You can exercise daily. You can change your stress. Decide on a job that's not as stressful as the job that you have. Or do something that makes you have fun to relieve the stress. Those are the things we can do to actually change our genes. And up until recently, we didn't know we could change our genes. And so we were doomed. Now there's hope that if we follow these different steps, that we can actually take a gene that's supposed to be for obesity, for example, and turn it off. So here's an example of this. When I got 23andMe back, one of the genes that I have that puts me at risk for obesity. I have two obesity genes. I inherited them from above from my ancestors. Now, those two genes could have made my life different and unhealthy, because had I just not paid attention to my diet, had my mother not been a vitamin and supplement expert, then I may have become obese. But I didn't become obese. And that is because my lifestyle was such, I didn't drink a lot, I didn't eat a lot, I watched my carbohydrates, and at a very early age, a very brilliant doctor in North Kansas City told me I was sensitive to carbohydrates and I shouldn't eat grains. I should eat fruit and vegetables, but not grains, and that I should eat more meat and cheese, eggs, that kind of diet. And so she put me on a diet that changed my genetics. Epigenetics actually worked for me. They made me healthier. So the other interesting fact about using myself as an example is that everybody in my family, my grandparents on both sides, were obese and died from diabetes or complications thereof. And I don't have diabetes, and I don't even have the genes for it. So if you look at my 23andMe, not only do I have to turn a gene off with my lifestyle, but I don't even have it. I didn't inherit it. Somehow I escaped this doom, which somebody else might think is unchangeable. Well, or is a done deal just because a lot of their family has it. You have to look at genetics as if you just look at family history, you have a huge range of things that could be wrong with you. And you aren't sure which one of those things you got. Even if everybody seems to have a certain disease, you may not get it. But if you look at the genetics, then you can see what your risk factors are and you can hone in on those. I could hone in on obesity and say, well, that's a very important thing for me not to get. I have to work harder to clean up my act, clean up my exercise, make sure I exercise all the time, make sure I'm active, make sure I'm not sitting, make sure that I am actually eating, I take a lot of supplements. I have to, because I don't eat perfectly and no one I know does. So, but I try to, and I eat whole foods and I try not to eat processed foods, not a lot of salt, not a lot of chemicals. All of those things are very important to turning that gene off. So that's what I've done. And my patients do it too. We work through this. If we know a very specific risk, we deal with that. If we know a family history, then we have to assume maybe that person has that gene. We want to turn that gene off. If they have a disease like cancer or something that runs in the family, we have to get that these folks to get rid of the toxins in their lives, like alcohol. We have to get rid of drugs. We have to get rid of smoking and any kind of tobacco use, because all of those things increase your risk for cancer. In addition, the epigenetics that turns the disease on is obesity. If you're obese, it doesn't even matter if you had a gene for obesity. If you're overweight and you have a lot of fat, you have a lot of toxins in your body and you have a lot of inflammation. Both things increase your risk of cancer. If you really want to decrease your risk of cancer, then cancer loves sugar. So you have to take sugar out of your diet. You have to decrease carbs. You have to stop eating breads. You have to stop eating cookies and candy. And those are the things you can do with that in your history. In fact, almost every disease is made worse by sugar and cancer and glucose. So then you can fight against it and turn your genes off by living properly. So you don't have to be doomed to the diseases of your family. Most of my patients come to see me so that they can be healthier and they can actually live their life at a productive level. They don't want to be depressed and sit around and do nothing. They want to get back in action. They want to turn the clock back. And the way to do that is through lifestyle changes. But one of the basic things that happens as we get older, because I was talking to all age groups before this, but now as we get older, to actually turn some of these bad genes off, we have to make sure our hormones are optimal. We have to make sure when we lose our testosterone that we replace it. When women lose their estrogen, that we replace it. When men get older, they make more estrogen, we need to counteract that. And a lot of that has to do with exercise and diet, and it has to do with getting your hormones back. If your testosterone's low, you are, believe it or not, if you're a man, you're more likely to have prostate cancer. Not high testosterone, low testosterone. And that is finally starting to be embraced. But low testosterone triggers the prostate cancer, and a healthy, high testosterone, normal testosterone, it turns that off. It is epigenetics. It shuts down that gene that causes cancer. So it's very important for you to know what you're at risk for and what can be done to shut it down. But in general, if we're just talking about getting healthier, you should look at your family history or look at your genes, hone in on them. I mean, family, you can have your own genes done by 23andMe for between $50 and $99 and have your health history given to you. But if you know all of that and you know what you're supposed to attack, then you need to see if you can make yourself as healthy as possible to turn the genes for whatever you were given that wasn't good backwards, and so you can turn them off and not be sick. It's so important to replace your hormones. It's so important to make sure you have a good exercise schedule. I don't care how busy you are. You have to take some time out for you. You have to decrease your stress. If your stress is terrible, I mean, your cortisol goes up and you don't fight cancer cells. And you, with high cortisol, you can get autoimmune diseases. You can get allergies. Those are things that you don't want to have. So stress is actually physically bad for you, and it can turn those bad genes back on and give you some diseases. So constant stress is bad for you. I have to say that I had to counter this. I was really good at eating and the exercise and that kind of thing, but I didn't ever control my stress before I started BioBalance Health and learned more about preventive medicine. My stress was off the charts because I was an OBGYN getting up in the middle of the night, answering phone calls all night, never sleeping. I mean, it's so important for you to take care of yourself, because even if you don't feel bad at the time, it catches up with you. I mean, after years of that, having high cortisol levels, when I'm running into the hospital for an emergency, that kind of thing, just the stress of it and just the lack of sleep caused me to have an arrhythmia. And an arrhythmia that now I have to deal with when I'm in my 60s. But I didn't necessarily have that when I was 45. When I was doing this, I had it later. So these are things that you have to think about and not just live in the moment, but live in the future and decide what you want to be when you're older and how you want to live and be productive and be mobile and enjoy your grandchildren and enjoy trips and the things that you'll have time to do. So I'd like you to know that your genes are changeable. You can turn them off. It is not a, it's not, you haven't been given a death knell so that you're going to be dying early. You can change it and you can do it yourself, and you need to have your hormones replaced. So I'd like to conclude with that and try to motivate you to be well so that you can be healthy the rest of your life. That's what we talk about at BioBalance Health all day long, and that's what we're trying to provide for our patients. We'd like you to subscribe to this HealthCast on YouTube, and it is, if you just check subscribe, you'll get this a notification of our HealthCast every week. And our channel is HealthCast at BioBalanceHealth.com. If you liked our HealthCast, please click the little thumbs up to tell us that you liked it. And you can also find us on Facebook.com / BioBalanceHealth.com, or excuse me, BioBalance Health. So please follow us on Facebook, follow us on YouTube. We'd love to see you next week.
Email your questions or comments to podcast@BioBalanceHealth.com. You can find the BioBalance HealthCast on iTunes and on YouTube. For more information about bioidentical hormone pellet therapy and other reverse aging solutions, visit BioBalanceHealth.com or call 314-993-0963. You can find Dr. Maupin on Twitter at Dr. Kathy Maupin and on Facebook at Facebook.com/BioBalanceHealth.